Hey, everybody. Welcome to today's Bible study. Man, we're so excited about that. We've almost completed an entire year. You know, hey, I want to congratulate you guys that have been with us ever since January, and where you have read almost the entire New Testament and have read the book of Proverbs over and over again through this year. Maybe you just started last week. That's okay. Hey, finish to the end with us. Well, today, hey, we're going to be talking about Revelations chapter 13 through 17. And I'm going to share a few things some takeaways that I had as I was reading this. Now, this portion of scripture here, it is filled with all these pictures and these symbols of what's going to happen, what's going to come. And it's been interpreted so many different ways throughout the centuries. And so we're not going to spend a lot of time on all the symbols and everything, but I'm going to pull something out of here because it's important for us to understand, and it's important for us to read this, and better yet, to obey what the Bible says to do. In fact, in Revelations 1:3, I love this because there's a promise here. It says, God blesses the ones who read the words of this prophecy to the church, and he blesses all who listen to its message and obey what it says, for the time is near. Now, hey, if the time was near 2,000 years ago, I think it's even more near now. And here's the great news. I'm blessed because I'm reading this to you, because I'm teaching it. And you're blessed because you're hearing it when you hear it and you obey it. So let's get into the word right here. In between chapters 13 and 17, my. We see this beast coming out of the sea. Then we see another beast coming out of the earth. And we see a lamb who is standing on Mount Zion with 144,000 people. And then we see three angels and a great harvest that takes place. We see seven angels that brought about seven plagues. And then we see seven bowls of God's wrath and a wicked woman riding on a scarlet beast. Now, I don't know, that could make a great movie. I tell you what, in fact, it seems like it's something right out of a movie we may have watched. But I'm going to tell you something. Let me give you the spoiler alert. The Lamb wins because the Lamb is Jesus, the Lamb that took away the sins of the world. And we have this promise in this portion of scripture that I'm going to share with you. There's a promise, but there's also a warning. And we have to understand, we can't just take the promises of God. We also need to heed the warnings of God. And so in Revelations, we're going to look at this verse here, Revelations chapter 16, verses 15. And it says here, behold, I am coming as a thief. Blessed is he who watches and keeps his garments, lest he walk naked and they see his shame. Now, this is a promise and a warning from Jesus. I mentioned to you about the Lamb of God. Jesus is symbolically the Lamb of God. He is the Lamb that was put on the altar of that cross and whose blood was poured out for you and I. And so we see this as a future event that Jesus is talking about. In fact, this is an event that the church has been waiting for 2,000 years to happen. In fact, every generation has had some kind of expectation that maybe he may come back during our lifetime. You know, the lie of the day back in the first century was that Jesus already came back and it's already done with. The lie today is, well, he hasn't come back so far, so maybe he might not come back in our generation either. But I'm going to tell you something. The Spirit of God always wakes up each generation to remind them that, hey, this could be the time. This could be the season when Jesus comes back, and we are closer than we ever have been in the history of the church. And so I believe God is reminding us again that he could come back today. You know, Jesus spoke about this when he was walking on the earth. In fact, he told his disciples in Matthew chapter 24 and verse 43, so you too must keep watch, for you don't know what day your Lord is coming. Understand this, if a homeowner knew exactly when the burglar would come, he would keep watch and not permit his house to be broken into. You also must be ready all the time, for the Son of Man will come when you least expect it. So Jesus spoke about this. Now, Paul also spoke about it. He spoke about it in 1 Thessalonians 5, 1 through 6. He says, now concerning how and when all this will happen, dear brothers and sisters, we don't really need to write you. For you know quite well that the day of the Lord's return will come unexpectedly, like a thief in the night. When people are saying everything is peaceful and secure, then disaster will fall on them as suddenly as a pregnant woman's labor pains begin. And there will be no escape. For you aren't in the dark about these things, dear brothers and sisters, and you won't be surprised when the day of the Lord comes like a thief. For you are all children of the light and of the day and don't belong to the darkness and night. So be on your guard. Don't be caught asleep like the others. Stay alert and be clear-headed. Now, there's some common denominators with both of these scriptures here. Number one is this, Jesus is coming back. Number two is we don't know when it's going to be. And number three is this, we better be ready. So let's break that down a little bit. Jesus, first of all, Jesus is coming back. You know, there's some theologians that believe when Jesus comes back, that that'll be the end of the earth and the way that we know it. And a new earth and new heaven will be made. Others believe that Jesus is going to come back and rapture out his church and take out his people and before the great tribulation. But we're not here to debate all of that, no matter what you may believe. But we all can agree this, that Jesus is going to come back and we need to be ready when he does. And so the second thing is this, is we don't know when it's going to be. It could be today. It could be tomorrow. It could be another 20, 30 years from now. We don't know when it will be. But there's a revelation here. In Revelations, it says that I am coming as a thief, and blessed is he who watches. And so he's coming as a thief. If you knew when a thief was going to break into your house, you'd be prepared for him. You'd have the police there. You'd be ready waiting for that thief. In Matthew, it says, so you too must keep watch, for you don't know what day the Lord is coming. And then in 1 Thessalonians 5, we read that the day of the Lord's return will come unexpectedly like a thief in the night. The third thing is we've got to be ready. In Revelation, we read that blessed is he who watches and keeps his garments, lest he walk naked and they see his shame. In Matthew, Jesus said this, you also must be ready all the time, all the time. And then Paul said in 1 Thessalonians 5, he says, be on your guard, not asleep like the others. Stay alert and be clear-headed. So Jesus is going to come back exactly when the Father tells him to. In fact, Jesus doesn't even know, the Bible says. He points that out in the book of Acts. Only the Father knows. And one day, the Father's going to turn to Jesus and say, it's time. And Jesus is going to come back. But here are some things that we need to do. And these are some things I've been applying and thinking about in my life. Number one, Paul said to watch. Jesus said to watch. John, the Revelator, he said to watch. We need to be on our guard. And Paul said in 1 Thessalonians 5, 4 and 5, it says, but you aren't in the dark about these things, dear brothers and sisters. And you won't be surprised when that day of the Lord comes like a thief. But you are children of the light. And of the day, we don't belong to the darkness and the night. We don't have to be caught off guard because we are children of the light. We have the word of God. We can understand these seasons. We may not know the day, but we can know the season. And I tell you, the seasons are getting closer. And then he says also, be ready, be on guard. John wrote, blessed is he who watches and keeps his garment, lest he walk naked and they see his shame. You know, the Bible talks about all kinds of garments and to wear the garments. I love what Isaiah 61:3 says. It says that he'll give us a garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. In Isaiah 61:10, it says, "For he has clothed me with the garment of salvation, and he has covered me with the robe of righteousness." We have Jesus's robe of righteousness. In Revelations 19:8, it says, "And to her he was granted," this, the her he was talking about was the church. "To the church he has granted to be arrayed in fine linen, clean and bright, for the fine linen is the righteous acts of the saints." Every good thing you do, every good thing you do in for the Lord is like putting on a pure white garment that the Lord gives you. In Ephesians 6:10-11, it talks about putting on the full armor of God so that we may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. So it's important for us to be clothed in these last days. And then the last thing he says is that we need to stay alert and be clear-minded. Here's what I'm learning. I'm learning that I need to watch and pray. I need to keep my eyes open, ready for when the Lord appears. Secondly, is I need to be prepared in these last days. I need to have that full armor on every day to fight against our enemy, the devil. And then thirdly, I've got to keep a clear head. And I do that by spending time in the Word of God, by renewing my mind so I can think clearly in these wicked days. Well, hey, thank you for spending time with me. I want to pray for you. I don't know where you're at right now in your walk with the Lord. Maybe you realize that maybe you're not ready today. I want to pray for you. And you can pray and you can ask the Lord into your life today. Invite him in. In fact, let me lead you right now. Pray this prayer after me. Father, I understand now that Jesus, your Son, died for me, and he rose from the dead so I could be washed clean of every sin, so I could be right with you. And I believe that with all my heart, and I receive the gift of eternal life that you have given in Jesus' name. And now, Father, I pray for my friends that you will bless them in these last days. Father, they'll stay alert, they'll watch, they'll pray, they'll walk in the fullness of your spirit, God. They'll be clothed with the robe of righteousness, that you will bless them in these days and help us to stay alert, help us to keep our minds in tune to what you are doing these days. And we give you glory and praise in Jesus' name, amen. You have an amazing day.